Hello, Grade 8 students! For today, we will be discussing mixture-related problems. In today's lesson, you should be able to solve mixture-related problems involving systems of linear equations in two variables. Let's have a short recall. What do we mean by solution? In science, when we say solution, it's called pure substance. For example, lemon juice. Another example is water. Now, when two solutions are combined, it's called mixture. In this topic, we will be discussing the mixture of two or more solutions, and then we will apply the concept of systems of linear equations in two variables. Again, we have the steps in solving systems of linear equations. 1. Represent the variables. 2. Equate the systems of linear equation. 3. Solve the systems of linear equations. And lastly, write your final answer. So without further ado, let's jump in our first problem. One can juice drink is 15% lemon juice. Another is 5% lemon juice. How many liters of each should be mixed together in order to get 10 liters, that is 10% lemon juice? I know that the problem is quite confusing, but with the use of our representations and the rest of the steps, we can solve this problem. So the first thing is to do the representation. So let's identify first what are the drinks or solutions involved in this given problem. So the first one is lemon juice number 1, and the second one is lemon juice number 2. In lemon juice number 1, it is stated that it has 15% of lemon juice, or the concentration of lemon juice is 15%. And then we are looking for the mass of lemon juice because we want to combine it to lemon juice number 2. That's why it is unknown, therefore we use variable x. Now, when we combine the mass and the percent of lemon juice, we will have 15x mixture. The same with lemon juice number 2. The mass of lemon juice number 2 is unknown, but the percentage of the concentration of lemon juice number 2 is 5%. When we combine these two, we will have 5y, because 5 times y is 5y. Now, in this given problem, we are asked to find the value of x and y, wherein when we mix lemon juice number 1 and lemon juice number 2, which is our mixture, the mass will be 10 liters, and then the percentage of the concentration of lemon juice should be decreased into 10%. All in all, we will have a 100% solution. How did we get 100? We just multiply 10 times 10. 10 times 10 is 100. After creating our table of representation, we can now proceed in creating equations. Okay, so let's proceed, or let's take a look on our representation. As you can see here, let's focus on our mass. Because we are looking for the value of x and y, we will just be focusing on those variables which are missing. First one is the mass, and the other one is the combination of the two mixture. So for the mass, we will have x plus y is equal to 10, and for the combination of the mixture, we have 15x plus 5y is equal to 100. Therefore, this will be our working equation in this given problem. Now, this problem can be solved using elimination. So we have our original equation, x plus y equals 10, and then the other one is 15x plus 5y equals 100. So to eliminate variable in this given equations, we can multiply negative 5 on the first equation. So our new equation would be negative 5x minus negative 5y equals negative 50. We just distribute negative 5 on all the factors inside the parentheses. In this given, we can now cancel the variable y because negative 5y plus 5y is equal to 0. Now let's add remaining factors. So we have negative 5x plus 15x, that is 10x. And negative 50 plus 100, that is 50. To find the value of x, just simply divide both equations by 10. So we have x is equal to 5. Now to get the value of y, just simply use either of the two. It can be the equation number 1 or equation number 2. In this given, I will be using equation number 1. So just substitute the value of x in our equation. So we will have 5 plus y is equal to 10. And using the addition property of equality, we will be transferring 5 on the other side. Therefore, we have y is equal to 10 minus 5. We can simplify this one by 10 minus 5 is equal to 5. Therefore, the value of y is 5. What do we mean by x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 5? Let's go back to our original representation. We are looking for the value of x and y. Therefore, the mass or x corresponds to the mass of lemon juice number y and y corresponds to the mass of lemon juice number 2. In this given problem, we are looking for how many liters of each should be mixed together in order to get 10 liters, that is 10% lemon juice. Therefore, the answer would be each juice drink must be 5 liters in order to get 10 liters, that is 10% lemon juice. So again, we need to have 5 liters of 15% lemon juice and 5 liters of 5% lemon juice. Let's have number 2. Walter White has 500 grams of a solution that is 40% acid. How many grams of water must be added to reduce the acidity to 25%? So again, let's identify the solutions involved. So we have Walter White and water. Given on our problem, the mass of Walter White is 500, the concentration of acid is 40%, and when we combine this one or when we multiply mass and the percent or the concentration, we will have 20,000. For the water, the mass is unknown, therefore that will be our variable x. And we know that the acidity level of water is 0%. Therefore, when we combine the mass of the water and its acidity, we will have 0x. Now, in this given problem, we need to mix Walter White solution as well as the water to have an unknown mass and to reduce the acidity to 25%. And when we combine the mass of this mixture and the concentration of this acid, we will have 25y. So now let's proceed in creating our equations. So again, focus on the topics or subtopics which has a variable. In this given, we have mass, which is 500 plus x is equal to y. And for the combination of the mixture, we have 20,000 plus 0x is equal to 25y. In this given problem, the best way to solve this is through the use of substitution. So we can rewrite these equations as 500 plus x is equal to y and 20,000 is equal to 25y. Sir, where is 0x? Always remember, class, any value of x multiplied to 0 will become 0. That's why no need to write it when you are computing for the value of x or y. So again, we can use the substitution method. So we can replace y by 500 plus x. So our new equation would be 20,000 is equal to 25 times the quantity of 500 plus x. Using the distributive property, we can distribute 25 to the factors inside the parentheses. Therefore, we will have 20,000 is equal to 12,500 plus 25x. Using the addition property of equality, we will be subtracting 12,500 on both sides. So, we will have 7,500 is equal to 25x. And to find the value of x, we will be dividing both sides by 25. Therefore, the value of x is 300. Now, to get the value of y, just simply use the first equation. So, we have 500 plus x is equal to y. And then just substitute the value of x to our equation. So, we have 500 plus 300 is equal to y. And we know that 500 plus 300 is equal to 800. Now, what do we mean by x and y? Let's go back to our representation. The variable x corresponds to the mass of the water, and variable y corresponds to the total mixture or the total mass of our mixture. So, in this given problem, we are asked to find how many grams of water must be added to reduce the acidity to 25%. So, we are looking for the value of x. Okay? So, the answer would be, the water must be 300 grams in order to reduce the acidity to 25%. Let's have our last problem. Soybean meal is 16% protein, while corn meal is 9% protein. How many pounds of each should be mixed together to get a 350 pounds mixture that is 12% protein? So again, let's identify first what are the solutions involved. So the first one is the soybean, and the other one is corn meal. Given on our problem that the percentage of protein in soybean is 16%, but the mass of soybean is unknown. And when we combine these two, we will have 16x. As well as with corn meal, it is stated that we have 9% protein, but the mass is unknown. And when we combine these two, we will have the product of 9y. Now, in this given problem, we need to mix soybean and corn meal to have 350 pounds mixture, which have 12% protein. And when we combine these two, we will have a product of 4,200. So, in this given, as you can see, these are just the same with problem number 1. So, our equation would be, for equation number 1, it's all about the mass, which is x plus y is equal to 350. And for the combined mixture, we will have 16x plus 9y is equal to 4,200. The best solution that we can do here is the elimination method. So, we have x plus y is equal to 350. And then the other one is 16x plus 9y equals 4,200. Just multiply both sides by negative 9. So our new equation would be negative 9x minus 9y equals negative 3,150. Just copy the second equation and then we can cancel negative 9y and positive 9y. Why? Because when we add these two, the answer would become 0. Now, let's add the remaining. So, we have negative 9x plus 16x, that would be 7x, and negative 3,150 plus 4,200, that is 1,050. To find the value of x, just divide both sides by 7, and the value of x would be 150. To find the value of y variable, just use the first equation. So, we will have x plus y is equal to 350. And substitute the value of x to our equation, we have 150 plus y is equal to 350. Using the addition property of equality, we will be subtracting 150 on both sides. So we will have y is equal to 350 minus 150. To simplify this one, y is equal to 200. What do we mean by x and y? X corresponds to the mass of soybean, and y corresponds to the mass of cornmeal. In this given problem, we are looking for the pounds of each solution to be mixed together to get a 350 pounds mixture. So the answer would be, we need to have 150 pounds of soybean and 200 pounds of cornmeal in order to get a 350 pounds mixture that is 12% protein. Now it's your turn. Solve the following word problems. For number 1, how many 10% acid solution must be mixed with a 30% acid solution to make 500 liters of 15% acid solution? For number 2, a chemist has to mix a 25% acid solution with a 35% acid solution. How many liters of each should be mixed to make 20 liters of 32% acid solution? You may pause the video for a while and we will reveal the answer afterwards. And here are the answer for our exercises. For number 1, there must be 375 liters of 10% acid solution and 125 liters of 30% acid solution to obtain a 500 liters of 15% acid solution. For number 2, there must be 6 liters of 25% acid solution and 14 liters of 35% acid solution to obtain a 20 liters of 32% acid solution. If you're correct, congratulations! That's all for today. Do not forget to access your Quipper accounts for a short assessment. Do not hesitate to ask Sir Alex and Ms. Rhea if you have questions. God bless!